You ever eat with a group of white people? Food be free. They be fighting over the bill, too. Tom, give me the bill, Tom. You paid the last three times, Tom. Tom, give me the bill. This guy. Tom, give me the bill, Tom. Quit being a prick, man. Just give me the fucking bill, bro. All right, now here's Uber money for everyone. I drove, but I took that Uber money. Never go eat with a group of blacks? Stressful than a motherfucker. First of all, you see the waiter walk up with just one check, you automatically like, yeah, damn. This motherfucker didn't separate these motherfuckers? Told this motherfucker 9 times to separate these motherfuckers. You ever try to catch your waiter by himself away from your party? Excuse me, you know where the restrooms are? Yeah, let me take care of mine right now. Hold it down, nigga, hold it down. Yeah, just my shit. Mm-hmm. What I have, the catfish nuggets. There's always that one bitch with a calculator. Okay, who had the 17 Moscatos? Felicia drunk ass. Bitch, it was you, because after the 15th one, I was like, watch this goofy bitch get 2 more of them, motherfucker.
I said, you don't need to offer up dessert. I'm taking care of that in the room. And he goes, okay. And he turns around like this and leaves. I'm like, I like Craig. So we start eating this meal, and every course that comes out just ends up being weirder than the next. It's too fancy for us. It's too fancy. It's a lot of foams and tentacles and shells, a lot of stuff from that ocean I keep hearing about. So everything is just a hair off, but we finally finished dinner, and I'm ready to get the night going. And Craig goes, hi, ladies. Who wants dessert? I'm like, not us, Craig. He goes, oops. I'm like, Craig, you had 2 jobs, bud. How could someone be so excited and incompetent all in one body?
I made the mistake one night of assuming the guy working the stand was Mexican. He wasn't. I even spoke Spanish to him, which is a no-no. The rule is, when engaging a brown person, you must speak English to them first, and then if there's a language barrier, then you go to Plan B high school Spanish. You start off in English. Hello, sir, may I? ¿Qué? No entiendo. ¿Qué pasó? Oh, hold on. I got this. Hola. Yummy. So I walked up to this guy at the stand, and I was like, you know, he reminded me of a tío. You know, so I was like, you know, hey, ¿qué onda, compa? ¿Cómo estás? And which is like, hello, friend, how are you? And he responded, what are you saying to me? I'm sorry, sir, I thought you were Mexican. No, I am not a Mexican. I am Greek. Greek? Shit, I was way off. I'm sorry, bro. It's late. I'm tired. Can I have 2 tacos? What do you mean, can I have 2 tacos? I just finished telling you I am not a Mexican. I am Greek. I do not sell taco. I sell gyro. Gyro? And then I remember seeing writing on the front of the cart, and I just thought it was like the guy's name or something, right? I was like, it spells it out. G-Y-R-O. Gyro. He got all pissy. It is not a gyro, it is gyro. That shit says gyro. It is gyro. Bro, I'm tired. It's late. What is a gyro? It's like a taco. Give me two. And by the way, if I'm the one telling you about cancel culture, it's already gone way too far. Because I pride myself in the fact that I'm not a comedian who's divisive. That's why I don't talk about politics, religion, or sports. Okay? Because all three will divide people. That's why I talk about food. Because food brings people together. That's right, unless you're vegan. In which case, you can leave right now. I don't give a shit, I really don't. I don't care if I offend you and your salad, you can leave, bye. And the only reason why I'm so on the vegans is because I once was vegan. Because yeah, after COVID, I wasn't sure what was gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? Like the only good thing I can say about 2020 for me was the fact that for some reason, I managed to lose 70 pounds. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, I lost 70 pounds. People ask me, what's your secret? I said, it's no secret. They closed all the goddamn restaurants. That's a secret. I didn't know how to cook. That was the secret.
You know when you're eating and you take like one extra bite too much and you can feel yourself gain weight because your bra gets tight? Do you know what I'm talking about? I call it the thickening. And boys, you need to know about the thickening because so many of our behaviors as women, you're like, oh, she just went crazy. Everything was fine. No, it was the thickening. It's not you. You brought us for a nice meal. It's not your fault. Every girl's been sitting there, you're like, I'm having the best time. And I'm,
uh-oh.
And get me out of here. And you should know, once the thickening happens, it's over. And it's nothing you did. We need to go to a safe space and eat more food, okay? That's what the thickening is. She's not horny. She just, you gotta get her out of there. No woman's ever been like, ugh, I just feel so gross.
Let's fuck it out of me.
It's over. Give it a beat. I was feeling so bad about myself and so mad at myself and just, ugh, just awful. And my husband looks at me and he goes, well, I think you're beautiful.
It's not about what you think.
Why are we even talking about this? Let's get some ice cream and enjoy the day. My wife quit sugar in January because she ate cookies. Like a monster, all through December. And on January 1st came marching into the kitchen. That's it, I'm never eating sugar again. Yes, you are. And you're gonna eat more than you ever ate before. And not because you're weak, but because you're a human being. And you get sad sometimes. And to stop yourself from slitting your own throat, eat a cookie once in a while. I have friends in my life that don't eat bread anymore. They don't eat bread. They don't eat bread. They're gonna lose 3.5 pounds. No one's ever gonna know. And they don't eat bread. Why are you even here? Could you imagine no toast in the morning with butter for the rest of your life? Kill yourself.
I feel like there should be a rule in America. They should say, you can hate immigrants all you want, but if you do, you don't get to eat their food. Yeah? That's a fair exchange for me. You hate immigrants? No immigrant food. And when I say no immigrant food, I mean no immigrant food, nothing. No Mexican food, no Caribbean food, no Dominican food, no Asian food, nothing. Only potatoes. And I'm not even saying like flavored potatoes, I'm just saying plain potatoes. No spice. Because no immigrants, no spice. Don't ever forget that. Both figuratively and literally, no spice. And I know some people would take that, I know. I know there's some people right now who'd be like, well, you know what, Trevor, take your immigrants, take your spice and get the hell out of here. Yeah, you say that now.
because you've never lived a life without spice. But don't ever forget, a life without spice was so hard, that it made white people sail around the world to find it.
And like,
this wasn't regular sailing. This wasn't like a Disney cruise. These people sailed at a time when they believed if you went that way, you would fall off the edge of the earth and die. And still, some man out there was eating some white lady's cooking and he was like, I can't do this shit anymore. I'm sailing that way. But what if you die? At least it's exciting.
No immigrants, no spice.
A guy by the name of David Maya, he came to South Africa to film a documentary. We became the best of friends. And one day we were hanging out in Dave's apartment. And Dave's chilling on his beanbag. And he looks over at me and he's like, Trevor, dude, I don't know about you right now, but I'm starving. I said, I think you mean you're hungry, Dave. So what? I said, it doesn't matter. What do you want to eat? So you know what I'm craving right now, man? I'm craving tacos. I was like, oh, that sounds like fun. Let's do it, man. Let's go to tacos. What? Isn't that the restaurant you're craving? Tacos? Are you being serious right now? You've never had tacos? I said, no, I don't know what tacos is. You've never had tacos? My answer hasn't changed from now, Dave. No. I've never had tacos. You've never had tacos? And by the way, I hate it when people do that. You know when people ask you the same question over and over again because they can't believe you haven't had the exact same life experience? You know that thing people do? Like with everything, they'll be like, oh my God, have you heard the new Beyonce? No, I haven't. You haven't heard the new Beyonce? No, I haven't. You haven't heard the new Beyonce? Oh no, now I have. No, I'd never had tacos, right? I'd never had tacos because in South Africa, we don't really have Mexican food, okay? We don't have Mexican food because we don't have Mexicans. They never came over, it's not my fault. Dave was personally offended. I'll never forget, he jumped up and he was like, dude, I cannot believe you've been in America all this time and you've never had tacos? I said, Dave, why is it such a big deal? He's like, because Trevor, nothing says America like tacos. I said, really? Nothing says America like Mexican food? And you know what's funny is I feel like in that moment, I feel like Dave was being profound. He didn't even realize it, but that was a profound little nugget that he had just espoused. Nothing says America like tacos. I've had the privilege of traveling everywhere in this beautiful country. I've been to places like Erie, Pennsylvania, El Paso, Texas, Honolulu, Hawaii, you know. I've been everywhere, and one thing I've learned across the board in America is that Americans love tacos.
Everywhere you go, Americans love tacos. Love tacos. Even people you wouldn't expect. I was watching the news one day, and there was a guy at a rally, right? And they were asking him about immigration and families being separated, etc. And this guy, like, regardless of his politics, like, he was being really mean and xenophobic and racist, you know, just acting real presidential. And the journalist asked him, about children, and he just went straight, and he was like, boy, I'll tell you what, I don't give a damn about any of these goddamn Mexicans, you hear? They came over here, they ain't supposed to be here, boy. Woo! Entire country now, you heard? That's right, boy, go back to where you came from. Woo! These Mexicans ain't done nothing good, they ain't brought nothing good to America, we don't need y'all. Come on, Bubba, it's Taco Tuesday!